Welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know about this video text function, watch the video till the end. And also, if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Okay, so today let's begin with the text function in Excel. Now, what is the usage? How we are going to suppose to use this? We'll be evaluating few examples to understand this in a much more detailed format. Let's get into the nitty-gritty of this particular thing. If we start with saying that, text function in Excel is basically used to convert the numerical value, all the numerical values into texts, okay, in Excel format, and that is specified. So it takes value and turns into text in Excel based on the numerical format of your choice. Now, Excel uses certain format codes, and we can apply these format codes based on the requirement to return a value. So it is categorized as text function in Excel. Now, if we start with the formula with text, it says value and format text. Now, value that we want to format and the format text is basically the code that we want to apply here. Okay, how to use this text function in Excel? See, the text function in Excel is very simple and very easy to use. Let's understand the working of the text in Excel by some examples. Depending on the situations and requirement, we can use text functions in Excel. On the first example, we have time and date, and this is what we want. So time and date here. So we want to display both time and date together in column number C. We want this two over here. And to get the values together as. So now we try to concatenate both the values and we get the values something like this, that once we'll start with, like, we'll say is equal to A2 and use an AND function here, then do two apostrophes, again use an AND function and say B2. You get a big number. If you scroll down it to Control D, you will get the same answer. So you can see that Excel displays the values of the date and the time, but this format is not clear and it's not at all readable for the user, because whenever we enter a data into a cell, Excel formats the date using the system short date format. And when we concatenate both these Excel functions, the system values for both date and time. So to make it more clear, readable, and in the desired format, we will be using the text function in Excel. Now for the time, we want to display it as hours, minutes, seconds, and use AM and PM here. A and PM, yeah, and the date as month, date, and year. So Excel provides a list of custom format and the format that we want. So we can check opening format cells window. So for that, you press Control 1. And on the Windows, you can use +1 in Mac to open up the format cells window. And you go over here to number and you see there are different formats that's been given. So scroll down and check for the format that you may require. Okay. Under this type of, copy the format date, time, and even for this, you have different sort of available things. So now in, let's say C2, we use, so now instead of that, you can use a text function here saying text the value that you want, let's say A2, comma the format text that you want, that is in R, okay, in minutes and in seconds, okay. And you want AM/PM, right? AM divided by PM, close the apostrophes, close the bracket, and use another AND function, one apostrophe, another one using say AND text function, use say B2 if you don't want, that will go beyond that. So see, you receive this kind of term. You have received 7 a.m. and the time. If you want, you can also input time over there to get date part also here. So if you want date, you need to add on to this saying AND apostrophe use AND function, then write again text, say B2, okay, comma, use apostrophe, month, day, and year, close the bracket. So you see you have got the date and time. Just do control D and see you will receive for all of them. So the format code has to be double quotes, else you know the text functions in Excel will generate an error as name. So if we don't surround the date format with double quotes, it will result in an error. Just let me remove this. It's not allowing me. Yeah, so just remove the code here. Let's remove both of them here. See, it's showing me name error, right? Now, next. In this scenario, Excel functions can also be used for the numbers with large values, for example, like telephone numbers, when a numeric value in Excel exceeds the value. So, these are all the numbers here. Okay. Excel always represents that value in scientific notation. As you can see over here, this is all in scientific notations. And suppose we have a list of customers with the mobile numbers in column A and B. Okay. The mobile numbers are given with their country code, different country code if you see over here. Right, so as you can see, so Excel converted this values into scientific notation format like this. So now we want in this in the format such that the country code and the mobile numbers could be easily be readable. So we can make it readable using the Excel text function. A mobile number, a country code contains 12 digits starting 2 signifies, you know, the country code and remaining is the contact number. So the format code we use here is hash. Okay. So we'll say that is equal to text. The value is going to be B2, this particular value that we want. And then use hash for that number of times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And the country code 11, 12. Okay. Close it. Right. See, you've got the whole number from here. Let's do control D. So you have got, as you can see, you have got all the numbers. Just remove one here. You'll receive one number less. 918801236548. So this is how you work on the mobile numbers. Now, if you want to make it more readable by separating the country code, then we will change the format code by simply placing a hyphen just after the two hashes. So let's do that here. Instead of this, just put a hyphen here and you will get an hash. So see, by country code you have got everything. Now text format can also be used, you know, while handling with dates. So while dealing with the dates, there is a list of format codes that is given. Now there's this function called concatenation with string. So suppose we have a list of children here: John, Patricia, Ram, Anita and Davis. They have a date of birth that are given here, and now we want to display the name and date of the birth in column C here. So like John was born on 8th of December 2015, and similar for other kids. So if we directly concatenate the name and the date of the birth, we get the value in the format something like this. You say is equal to John, use an AND function here, then two apostrophes, again use an AND function, and say B2, you get answer C, John, and the date of birth, but with numbers, but we want it in another format. So using the Excel text function, we'll be able to get the desired output. So the format of the, for the date specified, we'll use the format code as D, MMMM, and YYYY. Okay. We have done this. A2, that's perfect, and is perfect. Use an apostrophe. Was born, just write was born on, again closes, use another end, use a text function saying B2, that is the date of birth, I want in a different format. You are right now having a conversation with Excel that, you know, this is the way I want. So you'll say DD, you want in month and Y, that's year, close the bracket. See, John was born on 8th of December 2015. So in that fashion, Petrica was born on this particular date, and Davis, and so on and so forth. So if we want to use the abbreviations of the month instead of the full name, we will change it to triple M over here. Instead of 4M, we'll just use triple M. So it will use the short form here. Right. So if you want to display the date day with leading zero, it is single value of the, like, you know, 1 to 9. We will replace it D with DD here. We'll use D. So we'll just use D here. So it will change accordingly. Or D, or double D, or D. So it will change automatically. It will change. So depending upon the requirement, the format in which we want to display a value, we can alter the format codes, and we can also customize the built-in format codes depending upon the requirement. Now, example number 4. Suppose that, you know, we have, let's say, a gross and expenses amount, and we want to display in cell over here A13. So the net profit is over here. We all know gross expenses is net profit here. It's quite simple. But when we apply the text formula in the Excel, the net profit is basically calculated something like this. Is equal to, you say in comma, the net profit is, open the bracket, saying, and B11. So you will get the net profit is 52291. So the formula in A30 doesn't display the formatted number, which is in the dollars. So the revised text formula in the Excel that uses a text function to apply the format, the value is A13. So the net profit is text B11, and just use an A13 thing. So the net profit is, you open the bracket, use end and B11, or use an AND function, then use a text. You see the net profit over here, B11, and you want a dollar sign here, and always use a hash function there, comma, you say #0.00, comma, bracket close. So you'll get the whole as a part of the dollar. So the text formula in Excel displays the text in Excel along with the nicely formatted value, and the net profit is visible. So if you have learned and understood the video, enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on this video, and subscribe to our channel for latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.